Now, to 1/43rd scale collectors, Brooklyn is the stuff. These models are not what you'd call highly detailed, but they are unique in this hobby in that they're made entirely of white metal. Now, when I say entirely, I truly mean entirely, save for the windshield castings and the interior castings. Every bit of trim on the car is fashioned of white metal, and whether it's polished, plated, or just painted, it's all done very nicely and hand-built. This one is a stunner. This is a 1952 Cadillac Series 62 convertible. What a gorgeous model this is. Heavy too. The white metal adds a lot of weight to it. Of course, 52 was the 50th anniversary for Cadillac. They were powered by a 331 CID V8, making around 190 horsepower. You needed plenty of horsepower to pick one of these up. They ticketed for about $4,110 in 1952. Other earmarks for 1952 were gold V emblems front and back to celebrate their golden anniversary. Typical of Brooklyn, this is a beautifully built piece. You're not going to find any exotica on these. You're not going to see photo-etched emblems. But what you are going to see is a very heavy piece rolling on good rubber tires with just perfect finish all the way around. I love these model cars. I certainly appreciate the people who love them as well. This is sort of a cult, if you will, in the 43rd scale hobby. And models like this and subjects like this make these cars retail price of around $115 very reasonable. Couple that with the limited release that most of these models see and the panache of being a truly hand-built car that hails out of England, of all places, really makes a lot of collectors happy, including this one. Very, very highly recommended. So is this one. Talk about a different type of subject matter. This 1952 four-wheel drive Willys Overland station wagon. Didn't call it a Jeep, but I'll tell you what, it would be hard to mistake it for anything else. This was a really neat looking model. Again, offbeat subject done by Brooklyn almost entirely in white metal. And they really nail the shapes of these cars. That's probably one of the biggest things that Brooklyn brings to the table. Not a lot of fancy materials, just a great casting that's got all of the detailing. Of course, it's got the pointed grille and the pointed fenders. It's got the Jeep face on it. Full interior, very nicely detailed. Extra castings for the door handles on the side, again, done in white metal, and for the handle in the back. Taillight detailing and the distinctive Brooklyn license plates. They always have the Brooklyn marking on this to tell you what number they are in the series. That's a very British thing, and it's very cool. Let's collectors know what they have, what they don't have, and what they're willing to spend ungodly amounts of money for. Good news on this one is around the same price as all of the other Brooklyns. Expect to pay anywhere between $100 and $120 depending on how many of these things are left. What a cool, cool looking model car.